Lataifs and all that relates to these. First of all, what is Lataif or Latifa? This is a Sufi term parallel to chakras according to Hindu terminology or yoga or kundalini. The energy flows within the body and it flows in the form of vortices. These vortices are made up of smaller spirals of energy. These are known in Sufi terminology as Latifa as singular and Lataifs as plural. It means subtle manifestation of layers. And also these are known as 9 points of the self. 9 points of the self. According to the recent medical research, it shows that meditation has effects in various ways. Sometimes, many years ago, one person who was doing the broadcast narration of our radio program, her sister has problems, some kind of a hypertension or blood pressure or something. Doctor suggested that she should go into meditation. She used to attend the meditation sessions, and with that there was a tremendous relief in her condition. It helps in a variety of ways: breathing patterns, heart rate, and when normally we breathe haphazardly or the heart rate is very fast, when meditation begins to happen, the heart rate slows down tremendously, and slowing down of the heart rate means that less oxygen is being consumed and carbon dioxide elimination. So this is very important, that our heart rate needs to be controlled, and this also relates to the different kind of brain waves, the alpha, beta, theta and gamma. The brain waves fall below 4, that is a state of delta. Then one falls into sleep. When it is in theta state, that time the brain wave patterns is very fast or chaotic. So it has to be in a state between 8 to 10. These centers, their locations and these things are, this is known as in Sufi terminology, the 9 points of self. Of these, 7s are particularly important in healing as well as inward growth. Now the location of these is, the 2 of these centers are located above and below the heart, the biological heart. Heart is in the left side, 2 finger width below the nipples. So it is above and below. Then 2 are above and below the left breast, and 2 are below and above the right breast. 1 on the forehead. Each of these vortices is associated with different colors. I will not go into these. The 3rd eye center is known as Kalp Mudavari. The heart center is known as Kalp Sanubari. And the crown center, that Latifa, is known as Kalp Nilofari. The soul resides in these 3 centers. So these are known as Kalp centers. On these centers, Noor of this room remains. engaged in such practices that one can get this state of Mahavir. For this, zikr, meditation are the best methods. So let us look at the five locations that create the heart center or kalp sanubari. In the heart, on the left hand side, 2 finger width below the nipples is this place, center is the location for the heart. And if you place your hand there, you will get the sound of the heart beat. When the zikr begins, it is done at this center. It starts from that center. On the right hand side of the chest, 2 finger below the nipples, there is another center. When you place your hand, you can get a mild heartbeat sound. The third center or place is 4 finger width above the heart, and the fourth center is on the right side of the chest, that is 4 finger width above the second, and then the last or the fifth of this is in the center of the two breasts. All these comprise together these 5 centers, the heart center, 2 on the left and 2 on the right, comprise kalp sanubari or the heart center. These are also known as tajalliyat or panch prakash. The journey of the inward journey, when we start this zikr, we start from the heart center, and then energy begins to move to the different locations of kalp sanubari, and from there the energy moves to the other 2 centers, kalp nilofari and kalp mudavari. Their locations is very much similar to the third eye center and the crown center. The basic knowledge of this is not important when a seeker starts the zikr, or he is told a particular kind of zikr or practice to do, and when the seeker sits down in the company of the sheikh, he becomes aware of a particular center and he begins the zikr at that point. For the beginners, the most important zikr begins that you have to, the zarab has to be on the solar plexus. That is the center of energy, and that relates to nafs also, the ego center. So when the constant hammering is on that center, for instance, we use the zikr Allahu. When we say who, the zarab or the force, when you are releasing the breath, it is released with a force and it affects the solar plexus, it activates that center. This can be done in many other ways. For instance, using the breath. Chinese use the system of fire breath. Yoga uses the system of Kapalbhati, where you are exhaling. And when you are, because normally inhalation is a process that is natural, and we are sometimes, most of the times, remain unaware of it. We continue to breathe. So in the process of zikr, one has to become aware of the incoming breath and outgoing breath. So it happens we inhale more and more and we do not exhale. Exhale is a conscious process. So through this zikr, we exhale forcefully as much as all the carbon dioxide is released from the lungs. And with that force, it activates the solar plexus. This is the first where the seekers have to work on. Also, there are certain zikrs where the force, the zarab, goes on the earth center. So this is what has to be done in the company of the sheikh. And when the solar plexus has activated, energy begins to move, then the other centers, the work begins on the other centers until the seeker becomes aware of the 9 points of the self, 9 points of the root. When Hazrat Mazhar Mir Jaane Jaana Raziyallahu Ta'ala Anhu was in the company of the Sheikh Hazrat Noor Muhammad Badayuni Raziyallahu Ta'ala Anhu, so in one tawajjuh alone he became aware of the 9 points of the self. Sometimes the seeker, when they come to the company of the Sheikh, these 9 points are already open. Otherwise, the effort has to be made in different ways and means. For each of the seeker, because there is, God did not create man on assembly line like the Henry Ford has created the cars, or the cars are made on the assembly line. And then to identify, we use colors, we use the makes and chassis number, engine number, so on and so forth. But each individual is unique in his features, in his innerness, his energy level, and his inward growth. So when the seeker comes to the Sheikh, the spiritual journey is an individual one. There are certain things which are common for everyone. So when we have the congregational meditation sessions or talks, when the tawajjuh begins, it is like the flow of energy. Whether you generate the energy on your own or through tawajjuh, when Sheikh gives the tawajjuh, it flows towards, it begins to work on each seeker differently. I had given you the examples earlier on. In order to generate the energy, we can take certain exercises. For instance, when we start doing the zikr, who? For this particular way of inner growth, Osho has developed one of the important meditation known as dynamic meditation. It works at all the levels, the physical, the emotional and the deeper levels. It goes into five stages and which are very important. The first, as such, when a seeker comes, he is very lethargic, there is no energy, lazy. So in order to remove that, he enters into 15 minutes of chaotic breathing. So when you are doing the chaotic breathing, it activates the body. Then you enter into all the dormant parts of the body, they get active. Whatever emotions, whatever things have been suppressed, the body becomes active. Because on a day-to-day basis, when we interact in the world of objects and beings, we gather impressions and we go on suppressing these. By activating these, the body becomes active. Now, whatever kind of emotions it has preserved or suppressed, they begin to surface. The second stage is that of catharsis, release of the negative energy. This is done in the form of bodily expressions. You can dance, you can scream, you can talk, you can curse, anything that comes to your mind naturally you do. Because whenever we get angry and we stamp our feet, we shake our hands and feet, and we fumble because words do not form properly. And when an angry person is talking, you cannot understand what does he mean or what is he saying. This is catharsis. Thereafter, first the body was activated, the negative energy is released. Now you have to produce or generate the positive energy. That is done by standing and raising the hands. And with the force, you are using the word who. The first word in the zikr, Allah, is a dominant word. The second word, who. When you say who with the force, the effect or the force goes on to the solar plexus, the zarab it is called, and it activates that center. 15 minutes of this constantly, it generates the energy into the system. Now this energy cannot remain dormant. It has to reach somewhere. Either you can waste this energy or you can allow this energy to heal yourself. After that, next 15 minutes is a period when you go in. These are 10 minutes each period, and the last one is 15 minutes. So 4 is 10 minutes, 40, and 1 is 15 minutes. In this you completely freeze. The energy is constantly in the movement, and it moves in circles. Afterwards, when you freeze, it begins to go to those parts of the body, those vertices, those centers, those channels where it is needed more. It activates those centers. Sometimes a particular center remains inactive. Some of those who have been in the meditation on a regular basis, they would realize that the heart center is becoming more and more active. Love is beginning to overflow. Anger is naturally does not arise. This is the effect of the energy that happens through tawajjuh, whether it is a silent meditation or flow of the words as normally we do on these sessions, it begins to move. So the after the fourth state, where you freeze completely, there is no movement of the body in any way. Whatever position you are, you just freeze in that. Then comes the last state, the dance of celebration. Existence has fulfilled you. You are dancing in your own way as dance of celebration. You are celebrating this state of meditation. So this five stage of meditation is known as dynamic meditation, wherein catharsis, you release the negative emotions. First you activate the body. This is called in gym called warm up the body. After the warm up, you go into intense, and that can also be used as a practice of meditation. So when you sit down in the company of the Sheikh and he looks at your innerness, tawajjuh flows and it activates those dormant centers. Someone feels very emotional. Next one feels the tears begin to flow from the eyes. It is release of the emotions, and all these things happen when you go in the company of the Sheikh. It is a way of working on the Lataifs. So whether you are aware of it or not, the work continuously goes on, but it becomes relevant that you become aware of the mechanism of meditation or mechanism of tawajjuh, what happens in the company of the Sheikh. When Sheikh gives you a bath or initiation, it is given exploring your potentiality. Someone is given a name. When the Sheikh sees the inner potential, what this person will blossom as, he is directed to take that course. This is what happens when you are entering into the university. Sometimes you are aware of on your own of your inner potential, what naturally you find your lineage is towards this particular profession or that. So accordingly you choose the discipline to go into. Here the potentiality goes on. Some are, to some love is natural, but its flow has been blocked because of certain things. So that center is activated. In some, love is not the way, meditation is the way. So there, the meditative energies are invoked and it begins to work differently. If a person, that is why the Sheikhs in the Tariqat have emphasized on the seekers to get married or at least have the experience of male-female relation. So the work does not have to be done at that level. You can move to the other centers, because that you can work on your own under the guidance of the Sheikh. And when you are engaging in your male-female relation in a meditative way, which is the guidance of the Sheikh, or Tantra, or meditatively, you will begin to realize that when you begin your journey of the sex on a particular day, it begins with a chaotic breathing. As you become aware of the breathing and your focus is on the breathing pattern, it slows down, and in certain stages you will realize that you are not even breathing. The breath becomes, the breath movement becomes very slow, which is important, which is a state of meditation. But you are not falling into sleep. And in that state, when the act happens, you enter into the state when you get the first glimpse of meditation or satori, everything becomes calm and still. And this is the way that Tantra uses the male-female relation with breath, movement and awareness of it. When this is not possible, we use the other methods. To some, those who had entered into this male-female relation and because of certain reason exited, they have, their training goes on in a different way. They are asked to enter into meditatively into those moments when in the relationship they have experienced a state of extreme bliss. Even if the relationship has been abandoned or has to be denounced for certain apparent outward reasons, there would have been occasions of extreme bliss. You remember those moments. And also remember those moments when anger seeped in you. Then you had been absorbing this anger for so long within you. Consciously you have to release it, and when you release the anger, you learn forgiveness. You must forgive all those atrocities that the others have done in this way or that. You learn forgiveness. And when forgiveness is the stage comes, after that comes the state of compassion. Through male-female relation, it becomes very easy to attain. It can be done otherwise. Again, it depends on what stage the seeker is, what is his or her potentiality. That is why he develops each seeker in a different way, in an individual way. Although it appears that we are all together, but the tawajjuh works on each seeker in a different way according to his or her own needs or the state or potentiality. So someone is given a name related with love, the other is given name related to awareness. And Osho was an expert in giving the names to different seekers. He used the ancient names from all the traditions, whether it is a Hindu tradition or Islamic tradition or Tantra. He used, it is amazing how many names he had invented. Just as Sufis say there are 99 names of Allah, this is a symbolic. 99 symbolizes the infinite name. Hindus talk of 1,000 names of different aspects of the Trinity. Vishnu Sahasranam, 1,000 names of Vishnu. This is symbolic that everything, every individual is created in the name of God, and he has the capability to manifest one, at least one quality of God. And if we inculcate one quality of God, which is reflected through different names. Like for instance, when we use the word Majid, when we use the word Archana, when we use the word Arjan means one who earns for himself. Archana is an aspect of prayer. Aradhana is another aspect of prayer. Majid, magnanimous. And all these names have been used to be given to the seekers after initiation. It is not necessary, but sometimes the sheikhs use this as a device to bring a break in your past lives, that this name represents your inner potentiality. You have to work on this, and oh, this is the way that you have to reach. For instance, Saraha was a Brahmin. He was brought up in a Brahmanic tradition, but he was naturally inclined to the Tantra way. And he goes, and in the marketplace he sees an iron woman, brunette. He gets attracted to her. She became his master. This is how the Sarahas or Tilopa's Mahamudra in Tantra came into existence, or songs of Saraha. So all these are ways and means. It is myriad, infinite in number. As many seekers are there, as many people are there, so many ways and means are there for transformation of human consciousness and the techniques that the Sheikh uses. Looking at the natural inclination, he assigns a particular role, and also the seeker on his part has to realize that you do not get lost in that thoroughfare. If a particular thing is given to you to do, for instance, you are versatile in a particular way, archery, you go and learn the archery. You learn the archery and leave it. And when you are learning the archery, it is an effort. Afterwards, when you leave it, it becomes, as it grows in you as part of your own growth. Just as after conception, the woman gets pregnant and the growth of the child takes place within the womb. And when the growth is complete, the childbirth takes place. Whatever field you are excelling in, it is one aspect, you leave it for a certain period of time. It will consolidate in you, and then it will spring forth from within as part of your own inner growth. That is why one has to remain conscious. I did the cooking, I left it, because it is not me, it is not my way. I use the vehicle. These are the vehicles that we use to reach the destination. When you reach the destination, you do not remain sitting in the car. You have to hop out of the car and do what you need to do, and come back and sit down in the car and reach back home. So each technique is a vehicle that is given to you to attain to that state. When that particular center is invoked, I remember one day Khalifa Sahab Maulana Ahmad Ali Khan رضی اللہ تعالیٰ عنہ asked his Khalifa Hazrat Maulana Fazl Ahmad Khan رضی اللہ تعالیٰ عنہ, what do you do for your tarz-e-muashrat, means for your livelihood. He said, "Sir, I teach the little children in a primary school." He said, "Lahol wala huwat. This is the way of the masters. But really, you should be taking care of sheep." Now, why did Khalifa Sheikh Ahmad Ali Khan radiallahu ta'ala unhu told this disciple, this the Khulfa? He did not have a second thought. He went and he resigned from the post of the school teacher, and he took care of the sheep for 13 long years. It was a period of training. One day again, Hazrat Fazl Ahmad Khan was in the company of the Sheikh Ahmad Ali Khan radiallahu ta'ala unhu. The Sheikh asked, "Hazrat, what do you do for your living?" He said, "Sir, I take care of sheep." He said, "Lahol wala kuwat. You are an educated person and you should be taking care of the students, not sheep. What makes you do that?" Out of respect, he did not say that it was you who had asked me to do this. Had it been someone else who do not have akhlaq or the respect for the ways and means of the Sheikh, it is a very delicate method. The master-disciple relationship is even more delicate than the male-female relation. He went, leave the sheep and started teaching the school. The unique ways and means. When a particular thing is needed, Chachaji, one day he told one of his disciples, "You start crying," because his heart center was not getting activated. Their emotions suppressed. 3 days of crying was enough. So when you are driving, you know when the destination has reached on your own. The other passengers in the car will keep on inquiring, "Have we reached there? How long will it take?" What would you do? You said, "Keep quiet and have patience. I am the driver. I know where do I have to go. If I need your assistance, I'll ask you. I have my GPS system and I know where I have to go and I'm on the right track. And when I reach the destination, I'll stop the car and you know that the destination has come and we have to hop out of the car. This is natural." In the same way, the Sheikh works through his inner GPS system, and his GPS system is known as kashf or intuition. Intuitively, the same thing happens. When with the trust in the Sheikh, you are going for a job, with the trust in the Sheikh, you meditate and you will get the ilham, the instructions from him. If you are going to search for a new house or a piece of land, with the same way, when you go there, you take off your shoes, stay on the ground. There is a direct connection between your body and the earth because you are made out of the earth element. Direct connection, you become aware of the gravitational energy of land and then feel, how do you feel about this land, about this house, about this place. And your own indication will indicate you, this is the right place. The vibrations of this place is very good. It is in line with my lifestyle. then you don't need to seek the permission from anyone else. But in the beginning, if you do need, you can ask the assistance of the Sheikh. He may tell you, do this method and do that and so. But his emphasis is to make you independent of even him, so that you do not remain always holding the hands of the Sheikh and trying to find the ways and means. Even the child, when he grows old, and if you ask him, if you try to impose something and ask him to do this and that, he says, I am a grown-up person, I can decide on my own. That kind of independence, that kind of confidence, that kind of trust needs, one needs to grow into. And that happens.